Dr. Rick Ram.
Go Kansas. Thanks for the walk-up song, Scott. Awesome. Awesome. I'm going to ad-lib this thing. I'm so excited. First of all, welcome to Cypress College. Look at this turnout. Take a look at this. 50th birthday, 50th anniversary, what a day for the college. 1966 when this campus opened till right now. History on this wall, history in the gym, history in that trophy case, history being celebrated all day today. Today is an important day in connecting that narrative of Cypress College from the past to the present. Look at our Hall of Fame inductees sitting up here. First of all, congratulations, inductees. Great job. Round of applause for our guests of honor. We have a huge, huge baseball game against Golden West today, so we chose to do mimosas and Bloody Marys in the morning. The campus is celebrating a number of events, literally until our grand gala production of Follies tonight in our theater. And so this is an all-day event, and we're starting off right. So thank you for being here first thing this morning. You know, in this room today, we have faculty, staff, students, administrators who were here when it all started back in 1966 and who will be here into the future, including when we have football in a couple of years. I'm looking at our athletic director, April Fools. Just kidding, April 1st. We won't be having football anytime soon. But we have a president right now by the name of Dr. Bob Simpson, who says to everybody on this campus, including students, dream big dreams. And he talks about you should never limit yourself into what you dream of. And for this athletics department and for Cypress College, when I got involved, I said, you know what? There's so much tradition here. One of the things I'm going to dream big about is how to celebrate our history. I have a great relationship with Coach Don Johnson. Everybody knows our Hall of Famer and legend, Coach Don Johnson. I see him at all home games. Yeah. And Don knows from the time I met him and started really forming a great relationship with him formally about 4 years ago when I came into the division, I was telling him, you know, seeing your name on that court, learning about who you were as an athlete, your contributions as a coach, your TSU system, all those lessons. I mean, what an amazing story, but more importantly, what a rich part of the college. We have to celebrate that. So Coach Johnson's here today with his wife, Colette, his grandson, Blake, and other family members to celebrate. And again, what an example of dreaming big dreams and being able to celebrate that. Also here today is Diane Henry and Lou Kayayab, our former division office manager. And raise your hand. Come on, Diane. Don't be shy. There you go. Diane's right up here. And they deserve recognition. They helped you train a young dean like myself about the importance of this division. I have to be honest with you. Diane and I spent several months when she was getting ready to retire, and she handed me the keys of this Ferrari. And she said, good luck. Literally. That was without telling me the history of where all the skeletons were buried and all those other fun things. But anyway, she definitely inspired me, and Lou, with the nuts and bolts of how we work, have made it possible. Bill Pinkham's taught me the lessons of the U. Bill, raise your hand. This is our athletics director, Bill Pinkham. You know, Bill and I have a great relationship because he's a great baseball coach and I'm a great party planner. No, just kidding. So, no, but Bill and I joke around. The marketing, that's more up my alley. The administration, compliance, eligibility, that's up his alley. So when you put the two of us together, you have a compliant athletics department that looks really good and is recognized up and down by the state. So keep up the great work, Pink. Speaking of marketing, Wes McCurtis, raise your hand real quick. Bear with me for a few minutes. I got to get through superlatives and then a few updates on the college and the division. But Wes deserves significant credit. I was just up in Oakland for the California Community College Athletic Association Conference, and I'm sitting in a session on marketing, social media, and reach and recruitment. And as the two presenters were going through this, I pull out my cell phone all of a sudden, because for the second consecutive conference, they're highlighting the work that Cypress College is doing. The posters you see today, the design you see on this wall, all the invitations that went out, the coordination of events like this, Wes McCurtis is the man. He's definitely the SID of the year. So keep up the good job, Wes. We have a committee for the Hall of Fame. The plaque on the far left underneath the fire alarm light talks about the procedures, and we reestablished the committee. So over a period of time, this should evolve. We want to get it right. And so a group of us in the division got together and established what the procedures would be to induct our members that you see here today. So recognition goes to our faculty rep, softball coach, and inductee, Brad Pickler. Thank you for serving on that committee. Brad has a lot of history in this division, so he was a very wise contributor to our group. Thank you, Brad. Also today, you see our DJ back there, but actually there's a title that I think is more significant for Scott Tucker. That's the 2016 CCCAA Athletic Trainer of the Year. 30 plus years of service, outstanding job. Keeping our athletes healthy and safe, does a great job. Our division staff, you saw our host, Yvonne Cota, Pamela Brackman. I see Yvonne, Pamela's in the back there. They're the ones who run the division every day that the coaches, faculty, and staff, and myself get to interact with. Thank you for your support today. How about our student services staff serving alcohol in there and partying? I get to wear both hats in my title and my role, and you understand I have the best job on campus. I get to support students, I get to watch sports, and throw parties. I mean, it doesn't get better than that. Our foundation is Raul Alvarez here. I wanted to give him a shout out. Our foundation raises hundreds of thousands of dollars in support. They're actually really behind this 50th anniversary campus-wide day-to-day. The reason why the foundation deserves special recognition is they had a campus-wide process for divisions to request funds to market and celebrate the 50th anniversary. And this display, the wall of honoree for our Hall of Famers, is really a product of that procedure that the foundation had made available. So our leadership of Raul Alvarez definitely warrants consideration again, in addition to the shared governance groups that approved our request from PE and Athletics to have this event. So kudos to them. Also, someone who's been very patient over the last couple months as this has come together, my wife, Justine Rams, who's here, right there. We left our 3 and 1 year old daughters at home today so we could get a day out, but thank you for being here today. It means the world. So as we move on, I just want to tell you a little bit about Cypress College Athletics now that we're 50 years old, okay? A little bit about the division. Just bear with me. I'm going to go through a couple updates. First of all, our student athletes are very successful on the field and in the classroom. Our alumni are very successful. We worked with our research office and did a study, and using data going back from 2012 to 2015, we studied what happens to our athletes, how do they graduate, what are their success rates, and there were some awesome findings in that group. One, our students of color, our African-American males, our African-American females, our Latino males, Latino females are achieving at a much higher rate than the general campus population. Why does that happen? I could start with some of our coaches. I could start with our counselor, Dana Bedard. I could start with all the support they receive from yourself as family and cheerleaders of our athletes who do a great job. So our student athletes are achieving at a higher rate. We're closing the achievement gap with our athletes at a better clip than most of the other community colleges, and especially the general population at Cypress College. We're doing a great job. Our CCCAA organization has recognized our academic excellence. Just recently, Coach Pickler deserves kudos. Our baseball team, 2016 CCCAA Scholar Athlete Team of the Year. Huge congratulations to Coach Dale. And we're doing just as well this year, so keep up the great work in the classroom. One of the other endeavors that we have going, which is going to change the landscape for all of our future student athletes, is the forthcoming Student Athlete Success Center. We got approval on our campus and wrote, using data, a proposal to integrate case management services for all of our student athletes. And this summer, we will be hiring the equivalent of a full-time counselor. It'll be 2 20-hour-a-week counselors who will be case managing our student athletes and providing student athlete success services. Just like many Division I schools offer, we will now start offering that as well. We don't have a physical facility, so you might be sitting in the new Student Athlete Success Center, but it is coming. And I'll tell you what, for those of you who know me, if that Student Athlete Success Center has to happen in my office, it will. So we've just been very successful. You know, one of the other accomplishments highlighted by Coach Margaret Moore and her leadership, we also have the 2014 CCCAA Female Scholar Athlete of the Year, and Megan Hansen, who went on and transferred to UCLA. So again, individual accomplishments, absolutely. individual accomplishments, team accomplishments, teamwork as a division. These are all hallmarks of Cypress College athletes. And I have a few head coaches here that I'd like to introduce real quick. So I'll go around the room real quick as we could pop up. I see you in different sections. We have Coach Margaret Moore, women's basketball, with us today. We got, among our inductees, head coach Brad Pickler, softball. Our head coach emeritus for baseball, Scott Pickler. Assistant coach, athletic director, Bill Pinkham. Coach Drew Alhadif, men's basketball. Anthony Hudding, baseball. Larry Biedler, men's and women's swimming. Did I miss anybody? All right, very good. So, you know, these coaches do a great job. Beyond just the traditional classroom, which faculty in English, math, and our disciplines might think, what do PE faculty teach their athletes and their students? Well, they teach lessons that might not be in their traditional classroom. How to commit, how to push through tough times, the importance of teamwork, these lessons that our coaches do a great job teaching our student athletes on a day-to-day basis, and we see that reflected in Cypress College athletics. We're part of the Orange Empire Conference, and as you look up on our trophy case right here, you see that we've won 79 conference championships, 27 state championships. Now, what's amazing about those numbers right there is the Orange Empire Conference is pretty special. One of the deans in our conference did a little bit of research right before the convention that just happened up in Oakland, and I was blown away to learn that Orange Empire Conference schools have won 304 of the 750 state championships entering this athletics year. And since 2002, that number is actually 45% of all state titles. So for all the athletes, current, past, and present who are here, you are part of greatness as a conference. I don't even know if there's an equivalent level conference in terms of Division I or Power Five. You look at how it is, the Orange Empire Conference is greatness. And at Cypress College, you are part of greatness. I want to talk a little bit about 50 years at Cypress and what we do to prepare for greatness and how we're evolving as a campus in physical education and athletics. I look at Scott Tucker and I think about the improvements we've been making to the health and wellness of our athletic training facility. We've pumped in over $150,000 into our athletic training room, support for modalities, equipment, and supplies for athletic training. These keep our athletes healthy. These keep our athletes competitive. And as Bill Pinkham and I know, this is increasing the cost of the campus because we're very successful. All of our teams are qualifying for the postseason. We're winning championships, some cases back-to-back championships, or we're making deep postseason runs. So you're seeing improvements in athletic training. You're seeing enhancements in our fitness lab. We're getting students in there working out year-round, conditioning on equipment now that's modern, cutting-edge, matrix systems, cross-cable machines, power cages, and all the latest cardio equipment. So one by one, we're trying to update all of our equipment and keep up with the Joneses, so to speak. Our college has been investing millions in the restoration, renovation, and repair of our facilities. As you look down into Gym 2 right here, I hope you had a chance to take a look. You know, back in 2014 when Swen and Mark, when we retired your banners in the gym, we hadn't rebranded the courts. That was still in the works. But you'll see that our gym floors have been completely leveled and repaired and finished with current branding. Our recruits come in, our fans come in, and they love the experience. Our soccer field went through a $500,000 laser leveling renovation, and now we have one of the greatest pitches that are out there in the Orange Empire. Coming soon, new tennis court resurfacing, baseball field laser leveling in a new clubhouse, softball field laser leveling, and due to the passage of Measure J in our district, a new pool complex facility, which will have us have, I see some hands going up right on, a new fully competitive pool that could host conference tournaments and conference events. So we're very excited about that. We're getting an extreme makeover. This foyer you're standing in is getting an extreme makeover. How many of you remember the wood panel trophy cases along that wall? Come on, show hands, I just wanna know. How many remember that? All right, so now you take a look and we move the trophy cases over here. We have a wall of fame here, and we still kept the stained glass bar sign. How many of you had a drink and saw that in there? You know what I'm talking about, you saw that? We need to raise money for athletics, so I'll start the opening bid at $250 for that bar sign. Anybody? No? What if I throw in the old letters of the Jim Thorpe House Hall of Fame right here? What is it, 300? No? All right. Anyway. So we're rebranding. Come take a look at our baseball field. Come look at our windscreens on baseball and softball. Look at our championship history. Visit our tennis center and look at the signage that we have out there. Again, first rate, the commitment of the college, our leadership, and our coaches to make this happen. You know, we want to tell our story. We want to be able to connect our past to the present, but we also need your support. Inside your programs there, I'm going to put a little pressure on you to just consider this for a second. We're always looking for resources. There's some goals that the PE faculty have identified for the program. We want to, for example, extend our mural. If you've been on the first floor, you've seen Cypress College from 1966 to 2009. And what they did is they put our timeline. So a lot of the images that you see on the posters back there and in our marketing came from a big effort they made to document our history back in 2009. But now we need to tell the story through 2017. So we need some resources to be able to buy some of the things that the campus really wouldn't prioritize, because it's not really an instructional item for students. It's more kind of the marketing component. So we need your support. We want to extend that mural. We want to buy some supplies that are above and beyond the minimal needs for our program. So inside your programs, there's a pledge card in there. And if you're interested, we would appreciate your support. You don't have to write a check today. You don't have to do anything except tell us, if you are interested, that you'll support Cypress Athletics. Wes is the contact on that, and we'd appreciate any amount. We'll take it in denominations of $5. How about that? All right? So please consider supporting Cypress College. We appreciate that. So we're here to establish a tradition. Hall of Fame, 50th anniversary. First time we've had a group, likely of this size, to celebrate such an important day for our campus. Our sister college is also going to be doing their Hall of Fame next weekend, and they're going to be doing a little bit different event. We have to start somewhere. We don't have 100 years of athletics history yet, but we will one day. So we have to start somewhere. So today is an important day because we expect every 2 years that we're going to gather with our current Hall of Famers, our past Hall of Famers, and we're going to celebrate Cypress Athletics history. Maybe it will be here in 2 years. I don't know. Maybe it will be at a country club and it will have a black tie event. Maybe it won't. Maybe it'll be on the beach. I can't tell you what that'll look like. But looking at the interest we have around from this event, I know one thing. Folks are interested in understanding the story and connecting the past to the present. So I'm honored to be emceeing this event today and seeing history revealed. So speaking of traditions, we'll be having a Hall of Fame induction every 2 years, like I said. But more importantly, there's other traditions. How many of you remember this, Charlie the Charger? Remember this? A few folks? Horse? If you saw the bar sign, I think that was Charlie the Charger. Well, there's a new tradition now. And no Hall of Fame and no 50th anniversary would be complete without Charlie the Charger. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the most accomplished Charger of them all, with 79 conference championships, 27 state championships. Ladies and gentlemen, Charlie the Charger. So I've been asked by many parents when we're hosting softball regionals, just destroying Fullerton College. Parents come up to me because Coach Brad says, hey, go, there's our dean, go tell him. And they come up to me and they say, why do you allow that hornet on our softball field? And I start smiling and I say, well, I don't allow them there. They bring them. Well, where's our mascot? And I say, we'll have a mascot one day. So here's Charlie back in the flesh. Right here. For those of you who follow our social media, you know I love doing interviews with our students, our coaches, and administrators. So I'm going to do a little interview right now with Charlie. Is that okay?
Yeah.
All right. Sorry to put you on the spot. Charlie, who's your favorite coach to work with here at Cypress College? That's Coach Moore. Very good. All right. Do you have any love for our men's basketball team? Oh. It's all good. You excited to be back here today, Charlie? All right, so the plan for Charlie is going to be to make appearances at all, as many events as possible on behalf of the college. And again, without the support of our foundation, our college shared governance committees, we want to have Charlie. But more importantly, we want to help children in the local community understand what Cypress College is all about. So when you see Charlie right here, I know this is an athletics thing because, you know, March Madness is going on and you see all this. But think about the importance of Charlie reading to children in our local community, standing out on the first day of school with our students and connecting and building that sense of community and engagement. That's the purpose, really, of Charlie. So, Charlie, welcome back. We know you have a busy day. Thank you so very much. We're going to have you exit out this way. Thank you so much. Look at the excitement on our future Chargers right there. That's what it's all about. Look at, there you go. As long as he's not crying, that's a great sign. So we did well. Good job, Wes. All right, so without further ado, we're now going to get into the formal ceremony. Thank you for your patience through the first 10 minutes of those updates. It is now my distinct honor and privilege to introduce not only our college president, but honestly, one of the greatest Chargers that will ever serve Cypress College. Please welcome Dr. Bob Simpson.
Thank you for that, Scott. I really appreciate it. The Godfather of what? What a day. First, welcome to all of you. When I look around this room, I look at this wall, I see the excellence that's reflected in our athletic programs. It truly fills my heart. I know that for many of us in this room, in a lot of different ways, athletics helped to define us. And in some cases, it saved us. There are some incredible stories, and one of the things, as president of the college, I'm privileged to hear the stories of our students and the impact that our coaches and our intercollegiate athletics and our teachers in the classroom have on their lives. And being a part of that is really, that's what is special to me. I have announced my retirement at the college after 30 years in education. This will be my last year. So as I'm doing things, I'm not counting down the days yet. We've got too much work to do. I'll get to that after graduation. There are events as they happen that I'm more appreciative of. Things like this today where we get to recognize what we at the college are a part of. And I call it the Charger family. Being a member of the Charger family is what's special to me. And I've said, and I will continue to say, I don't have any singular achievement at the college. But I have lots of achievement as members of these incredible teams here. And that's what has been special to me. I also think about our opportunity to have an impact and to leave a mark. And again, my views of that have changed. And when I was younger, I wanted to do something and be recognized for that. And as I've matured and grown, what I've recognized, what's important is to engage in the work we need to engage in so that when we are no longer doing that work, what we hand off to those who will be doing that work is something that we can be proud of. At Cypress College, we have core values: excellence, integrity, collegiality, and inclusiveness. And those qualities are reflected in all of our athletics programs. And that is nurtured by administrators, by coaches, by assistant coaches and by assistants, and it is ingrained in our student athletes. And when you look at the achievements athletically, 27 state championships, 79 conference championships, those are impressive. And we've got some incredible names on this wall, people who certainly deserve to be there. But what they're nurturing is not so much what's happening in the classroom. And as Dean Ram said, when we hear that Coach Pickler and his men's baseball team have earned the Scholar Athlete Team of the Year for the California Community College Athletics Association. That happens on a consistent basis here at Cypress College because all of our coaches know what matters. And what matters is not so much those wins and losses. It's the character that our student athletes develop. It's the drive to be successful and to be good people, those life lessons that matter. And I'm so proud that all of our coaches focus on that for our student athletes. And it's reflected certainly by the excellence that are achieved by so many of our honorees, but more so it's reflected by the kinds of people they are when they leave our doors and they transfer, go on to the other aspects of their lives. You know, there are some indications of the commitment of our PE division, soon to be our kinesiology division, to academics. We had an opportunity a few years ago, 3 years ago, to hire a new full-time faculty member in the PE division. And our coaches and staff members got together and they said, what we need is some help with academics. And we hired Dr. Sylvie Grody, who came to the college and has and I know that Brad is really sad about this, but she took over fundamentally the curriculum committee duties from Brad, and but he was willing to hand that off. And Sylvie has come here and built a kinesiology program. We're going to have transfer degrees in kinesiology. She's built the curriculum, and she has the skills that, quite frankly, not all of our coaches have with respect to curriculum development and academic development. But again, that's a reflection, the fact that they were willing to sacrifice potentially a head coaching position to make sure that our students had what they need in the classroom. And I'm so proud of that fact. When I think about transfer, and I see that we've got some Bruins here in the audience, and I myself got my doctorate at UCLA, so we've got strong connections. And Coach Johnson, of course, one of John Wooden's first All-Americans. And having those kinds of connections is special. With all of our Bruin connections, I would lead you all in the A class, but I know that we've got some Trojans in the audience, and they get confused with the math, so we won't go there. One of the things that I think I'm known for at the college is delegating. And so I'm going to bring my remarks to close, and I'm going to delegate it to Dean Rams and hand the program back to him. But I do want to say that it has been such a privilege for me to be able to support the work of this division. And when I see our student athletes, especially here, to be recognized, we are so proud of your achievements. And again, what you achieved in the pool, on the court, on the fields, we rejoice in that. But more importantly, the kind of people you have become, it makes us very, very proud. Go Chargers!
It's ceremony time now, so I'm going to go over the logistics with our Hall of Famers so you know what to expect. David Soto, the voice of the Chargers, is going to come up here, and he's going to emcee the ceremony portion. When he begins the ceremony, as he does the introductions, the Hall of Famers are going to stay seated. So he's going to read a brief bio about you. When he concludes that bio, you're going to stand up and you're going to come walk over right to that blue X on the floor in front of the media wall. At that point, I'm going to hand you your commemorative medal, your Hall of Fame medal. As I'm handing it to you, Wes McCurtis, our sports information director, is going to take one photo of us doing the handoff. And then I'm going to step back and he's going to take a solo shot of you displaying your medal. Also for you, Assemblywoman Sharon Quirk Silva, our local Assemblywoman, has provided us certificates of recognition for each of all Hall of Famers today. We apologize, there are a couple missing. We were communicating with our office up to the 11th hour. I do apologize, we're going to mail those off to those who we do not have here as well. And then for our baseball alumni, we also have a jersey presentation for you as well. Okay, so that's how the ceremony is going to operate. And then after the pitcher, you're going to take a seat and we'll acknowledge the next Hall of Famer. So without further ado, it's now my pleasure to introduce the current voice of the Chargers, David Soto.
Well, thank you very much, everybody, and what a tremendous turnout. A big round of applause for all of those in attendance, as well as our Hall of Fame class. All right. All right, so let's get underway. We have a very large class that we want to get to, and again, Rick did tell you the procedures, so you're just going to sit down, I'm going to read your bio, and then once we say your name, feel free to get up and take a nice picture. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. In 1973, just 7 years after the opening of the campus, the Chargers saw one of its first student athletes move on to participate in the professional ranks. As a member of the Cypress College men's basketball team, he was named the Conference Player of the Year while being selected to the All-American team and All-State team. He went on to play for John Wooden at UCLA, where he helped lead the Bruins to 2 national championships before his selection in the first round of the 1973 NBA draft by the Milwaukee Bucks. He was the ABA Rookie of the Year and a 2-time ABA All-Star. He's the only player in history to have led the ABA and NBA in rebounding. He ranks 10th all-time in the NBA field goal percentage ranking and is a member of the NBA's exclusive 30-30 Club. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Cypress College Hall of Famer, Swen Nader. Swen lives in Washington with his wife, Wendy, and currently works as a buyer for Costco Wholesale.
Dr. Sims has said there might be some Trojans fans out here. So Dave, I recommend you speak a little more slowly.
Trojans. It's nice to see we have a big Costco fan section over here. Very nice. All right. Our next inductee. As a member of the Cypress College softball team, she was a member of the 2010 CCAA state champion team, where she was named state tournament MVP. She was a 2010 All-Orange Empire Conference selection and finished 2nd all-time in triples and slugging percentage at Cypress College. She went on to become a 2-year starter at Concordia University, where she was a 2-time All-Golden State Athletic Conference selection, a first-team All-American, and a 2012 Golden State Athletic Conference Player of the Year. She played 3 seasons of professional softball in Italy before returning to the States to play in the National Pro Fast Pitch League with the Houston Scrapyard Dogs. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Amanda Fama. Amanda currently works as a PE teacher for schools throughout Irvine and is on the coaching staff at Concordia University while continuing her professional softball career. Once again, Amanda Fama, ladies and gentlemen. Up next. As a member of the Cypress College swim team, he was the 2012 Orange Empire Conference champion 100-yard breaststroke and a CCAA state qualifier in the 100 and 200-yard breaststroke. He was a 2-time All-American selection and currently holds the Cypress College record for the 100-yard breaststroke and the 200 free relay. He received a scholarship to swim at Oklahoma Baptist University. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Damon Chandler. Our next inductee, as a member of the Cypress College softball team, she was a member of the 1997 and 1999 CCAA state championship and Orange Empire Conference championship team. She also played a role during her redshirt season on the 1998 state championship and Orange Empire Conference championship team. She was a 1997 All-American selection, the 1999 Orange Empire Conference Player of the Year, the 1999 State Championship Tournament MVP, and the 1999 Easton Player of the Year. She received a scholarship to play softball at Kennesaw State. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Melissa Beck. Melissa is currently ophthalmic? Is that? Oh, it's an ophthalmologist. All right. Even easier. She's an ophthalmologist, assistant, and surgery technician. She lives in Florida with her husband, Anthony, and two children, Mia and Bella. Up next, he was a member of the 1990 Cypress College baseball team before being selected by the Seattle Mariners in the 63rd round of the 1991 MLB draft. He climbed the minor league ranks to make his major league debut with the Mariners in 1998. He was a member of the 2001 Seattle Mariners, who won an MLB record 116 games and played in the World Series in 2005 as a member of the Houston Astros. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Charles Gibson. Charles currently works as an athletics director and baseball coach at Xavier Education Academy in Houston, Texas. He also serves as chairman of the board for Children for Tomorrow, a nonprofit organization that focuses on helping emotionally abused children and families going through divorce. He has two children, Charlie and Dylan. Once again, Charles Gibson. All right. Our next inductee as a member of the Cypress College softball team. She was a member of the 1993 CCAA State Runners-Up and 1993 Orange Empire Conference Championship team. She was a 1993 All-Orange Empire Conference First Team selection, 1993 Orange Empire Conference Player of the Year, 1993 All-Southern California Team Selection, and 1993 State Tournament MVP. She received a full-ride scholarship to Arizona State University, where she was a two-year starter, racking up 101 hits, 55 RBI, and 52 runs on her way to becoming an All-Pacific Coast Conference Honorable Mention. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Carrie Maloney. Is currently a detective for the Arizona Department of Corrections and serves as a member of the Fugitive Apprehension Team, in case that's important to anybody here. She'll have business cards. No. All right. Here we go. Our next inductee. As a member of the Cypress College men's basketball team, he was a 1980 CCAA state champion. He was selected to the 1980 All-State team and is the second all-time leading rebounder in school history. He transferred to play 2 years under Coach John Wooden at UCLA before being selected in the fourth round of the 1982 NBA draft by the Utah Jazz. He was a 1989 NBA All-Star, two-time NBA Defensive Player of the Year award winner, and three-time All-Defensive First Team selection. He is the NBA record holder for blocked shots and has his number 53 retired by the Utah Jazz. Standing at 7'4", Hall of Famer for Cypress College, Mark Eaton. Works as a business motivational speaker and lives in Utah with his wife, Terry. They have six children, Nick, Doug, Whitney, Haley, Courtney, and Shelby, and two lovely grandchildren, Nora and Liam. Once again, Mark Eaton, ladies and gentlemen. If you can please take your seat, Mark. All right. Our next inductee. As a member of the Cypress College swim team, she won the 2013 50-yard freestyle Triple C AA State Championship and 2013 50-yard freestyle Orange Empire Conference Championship. She was an 11-time All-American selection and is still the conference record holder for the 50-yard freestyle. She currently holds the Cypress College women's swimming record for the 50-yard and 100-yard and 200-yard freestyle. She received a scholarship and went on to continue her swim career at Cal State Bakersfield. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Jacqueline Youngerman. Jacqueline is currently a dental hygienist student living in Cerritos, California. All right. Oh, very nice. And now our next inductee. As a member of the Cypress College baseball team, he was a member of the 1997 state championship team. He was a 1997 All-Orange Empire Conference first team selection, 1997 All-State selection, and the 1997 state tournament MVP. He moved on to play baseball at Wake Forest University, where he won back-to-back ACC titles and was selected to the 1999 All-ACC second team. He was selected in the 31st round of the 1999 MLB draft by the San Francisco Giants and spent three seasons playing in the minor leagues. He is currently an assistant baseball coach for the Georgia Bulldogs. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Scott Daly. Announcement needs to be made, I think, right? This, despite what you may think, is not Scott's sister. This is Scott's mom, Linda, ladies and gentlemen. Excellent. All right, onward and forward. Our next inductee, a member of the Cypress College softball team. She won back-to-back Triple C AA state championships in 2011 and 2012. She was a 2011 All-Orange Empire Conference first team selection, 2011 All-Southern California team selection, and a 2011 All-State tournament team selection. She was the 2012 Orange Empire Conference MVP. A 2012 Triple C AA All-State selection and a 2012 Triple C All-State Golden Glove recipient. She went on to continue her softball career at the University of California, Santa Barbara. Ladies and gentlemen, the accomplished Hall of Famer for Cypress College, Jessica Reitner. Jessica currently works as a registration specialist at an audiovisual company in Huntington Beach, California. Once again, Jessica Reitner. Our next inductee as a member of the Cypress College baseball team. He helped lead the program to its first ever conference title in 1989. He was a two-time first team All-Orange Empire Conference selection, the 1989 Conference Player of the Year, 1989 Junior College All-American, 1989 All-Southern California Team Selection, and the 1989 All-State Selection. He received the Big Stick and Golden Bat Awards at Cypress before being selected in the 11th round of the MLB draft by the Boston Red Sox. His pro career spans 7 seasons in minor leagues with the Boston Red Sox, Baltimore Orioles, and Seattle Mariners. He was the 1994 batting champion of the Florida State League and 1994 Player of the Year for the Sarasota Red Sox. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Jason Friedman.
Yeah! There's no crying in baseball!
Jason went on to graduate from Loyola Law School and has been a lawyer in Long Beach since 2000. He currently lives in Rossmore, California with his wife Jennifer and their 2 children, Nick and Lauren. Once again, Jason Friedman. Done, sir. Okay. Our next Hall of Fame inductee, a member of the Cypress College women's basketball team. She led the Lady Chargers to their first ever CCAA state championship in 2005. She was selected the 2005 CCC state tournament MVP and was a 2-time All-Orange Empire Conference first team selection. She currently ranks 2nd all-time in assists and top 10 all-time in steals. She received a full-ride scholarship to play basketball at San Jose State University, where she was a 2006 All-Conference selection, as she led the Western Athletic Conference in assists and assists-to-turnover ratio. She also excelled as a student, graduating magna cum laude. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Brittany Mbaku. Assistant while she attends Long Beach State University to get her credential in physical education. She also served as an assistant coach on Cypress College's women's basketball team for the past 2 seasons, where the Chargers have won back-to-back Orange Empire Conference championships. Onward and forward as we go to our next inductee. As a member of the Cypress College softball team, she was a 2006 CCAA state champion. In 2006, she was named MVP of the state tournament, MVP of the Orange Empire Conference, Southern California Player of the Year, and was selected as an Eastern All-American. In 2007, she earned the Orange Empire Conference's Most Valuable Pitcher Award, Southern California Pitcher of the Year, and was again selected as an Eastern All-American. She still currently holds the single season record for hits and strikeouts at Cypress College. She went on to continue her softball career at Lubbock Christian University, where she was a 2-time All-Conference first team selection and a 2-time All-American. She still holds the NAIA record with a 90.4, call it 91%, win percentage on the mound. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Alyssa Gutierrez. Alyssa is currently in her 3rd year as an assistant coach with Cypress Softball, where she focuses on developing the Chargers' pitching staff. Ladies and gentlemen, Alyssa Gutierrez. And now, ladies and gentlemen, as the first ever head men's basketball coach at Cypress College. He captured the college's first ever team, CCAA state championship in 1977, followed by another CCAA state championship in 1980. As the leader of the Chargers, he became the all-time winningest men's basketball coach in CCAA history, with 588 career wins, including among them 7 conference titles. As a player at UCLA, he became John Wooden's second ever All-American selection in 1951 and 1952. He was inducted into the UCLA Hall of Fame in 2013 and had the court in Gym 2 at Cypress College, featured right over here, named in his honor. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor to introduce Cypress College Hall of Famer, Coach Don Johnson. In the midst of a legend, right here, right now, huh? He's debating. Go ahead. You can say something.
One of my recollections was Judy Mercandotti told me years ago, she said, "Don, you need to smile more." That's something I never quite learned to do, I think. But in hindsight, I realized what a great honor and great privilege it was to teach and coach here, and what an awesome responsibility to work in the lives of young people. And sometimes I think I cared a little bit too much, but then again, all I really wanted to do was get home to Colette and my family. And the guys who are here today make it seem all worthwhile.
Love you, Coach. Yeah. Coach Don Johnson, ladies and gentlemen. Very touching, very moving, very nice. Our next inductee, as the head baseball coach at Cypress College, he led the Chargers to 5 CCAA state championships, 4 CCAA state championship runners-up, and 6 Orange Empire Conference championships on his way to becoming the second all-time winningest baseball coach in CCAA history, with 981 victories over his 32 seasons at the helm. He has helped over 300 student athletes earn baseball scholarships. He's seen more than 120 of his players selected in the MLB draft. He was the 2016 CCAA Coaching Achievement Award recipient and was inducted into the Savannah High School Hall of Fame. He has led his Cape Cod League team, the YD Red Sox, to 6 Cape Cod League titles and is the first coach in history to complete a three-peat in the Cape. Ladies and gentlemen, with great distinction, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Scott Pickler.
I'm somewhere on a beach, sipping something strong, got an
wife of over 40 years, Sharon, live in Anaheim, California. They have two children, Carrie and Jeff, and two wonderful grandchildren, Bailey and Brent. Scott is still a member of the baseball coaching staff with the honorary title of Head Coach Emeritus. Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Brad Pickler. Oh, sorry, Scott. All right. Scott Pickler. You can go now. They're right under each other. almost. Oh, man. All right. Well, hey, we're getting to you now, so get ready. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, couldn't have been a junior. That would have totally hit in that. Our next inductee, the head coach, head softball coach at Cypress College. He's led the Chargers to a state record 8 triple C's, double A state softball championships, and 21 Orange Empire Conference championships. He was featured in Sports Illustrated's Faces in the Crowd section in 1997. He's made 25 triple C, double A state tournament appearances while sending over 90 student athletes on to play at four-year universities. He is the recipient of 16 Orange Empire Conference Coach of the Year Awards, numerous Triple C AA Coaching Staff of the Year Awards, and was recently inducted into the Savannah High School Hall of Fame. He is the winningest college softball coach of all time at any level, with over 1,200 wins and counting. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Coach Brad Pickler! California with his wife Noelle and their two children Paige and David. He is still a full-time faculty member and head softball coach at Cypress. Once again, Brad Pickler. Oh, very nice. All right, here we go. Our next inductee, as the athletics director at Cypress College, he's been essential to the growth and development of the college's athletics program and facilities. He oversees eligibility, transportation, game management, and department hiring for the college's 14 intercollegiate sports, while also helping lead one of the nation's top community college baseball programs as the assistant baseball coach since 1985. He has been a part of 5 Triple C Double A baseball state championships and 6 Orange Empire Conference championships. On Memorial Day weekend this May, Bill will become the first ever assistant coach to be inducted into the California Community College's Baseball Coaches Association Hall of Fame in Fresno, California. In his playing days, he was an All-American catcher at the University of San Diego before being selected in the second round of the 1981 MLB draft by the Toronto Blue Jays. An honor and a privilege to introduce Cypress College Hall of Famer, Bill Pinka. Director and assistant baseball coach at Cypress College. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Bill Pinkham. Right. out of medals there, huh? But we got the good stuff coming at you guys here. Our next inductee. Oh, he spent 22 seasons as the official voice of the Chargers. His voice could be heard announcing the starting lineups during play out at the baseball field or in Don Johnson Gym at the men's and women's basketball and women's volleyball games. He has called well over 1,000 Cypress College home games, and his tenure includes 5 CCAA state championships, 12 Orange Empire Conference championships. He is well respected by the campus, the CCAA, and the Orange Empire Conference. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Wyatt Ware!
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dan Patrick, Stuart Scott, and Kenny Bay.
Welcome to the Big Show.
Booyah!
I am amused by the simplicity of this game.
Can I get a witness from the congregation?
Dare I say, in fuego. Ladies and gentlemen, in the unlikely event of a water landing, please use third base as
Wyatt,
a dislocation device.
Wyatt had a short stint as a spotter at Cal State Fullerton Basketball and is looking for ways to stay involved in athletics. He currently lives in Wildomar, California, with his wonderful parents, Mark and Debbie. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Wyatt Ware.
You can only hope to contain him.
You know that kid is butter because he's on a roll.
I do it.
We rock the heart of the rocks that we have to win.
I am king of the diamonds. That could be a grand club.
All right.
The finest meats and cheeses in all the land.
Fat mojo.
Our next inductee. As an assistant men's basketball coach and full-time chemistry instructor at Cypress College, he inspired students on and off the court. According to a former player, he knows his subjects deeply, he said, not just the how, but the why. He provided a setting for self-discovery in the classroom and at practice. He taught a desire for excellence and made you believe in yourself. As an assistant coach, he played a vital role on the 1977 and 1980 CCAA state championship teams. And as a chemist, he has published over 25 papers related to soil and agronomy. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Tom Lubin. Been retired from higher education since 1999, but he continues to consult on golf courses and AG projects worldwide. He currently lives in Norco, California, with his wife, Dorothy Lubin. They have 2 wonderful children, Kara and Laura. Once again, Tom Lubin. All right, here we go. Our next inductee. As a volunteer for Cypress College Athletics, he has been an absolutely essential part of the game, both in its management and the events for the athletics department. He has been with Cypress College for over 20 years. After playing wheelchair basketball for Cypress College, he began working as the scoreboard operator for softball back in 1992 and has since taken on the same role for baseball, men's basketball, women's basketball, volleyball, men's soccer, and women's soccer. Along with his scorekeeping duties, he always keeps the crowd hyped with a never-ending playlist of hit songs. Ladies and gentlemen, the legend, Cypress College Hall of Famer, George Torres! In Buena Park, California. California with his girlfriend, Linda. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, George Torres. I see we have our final two medals to give out and another two wonderful, amazing people to introduce. He spent 40 years as a Cypress College charger, filling numerous roles on campus. He was essential in laying the foundation for the college's PE division and its athletic programs. He served as an assistant football coach, head golf coach, head baseball coach, and dean of PE athletics. He also influenced the college in other areas while serving as the dean of fine arts and dean of science, engineering, and math. As vice president and as vice president of student support services, ladies and gentlemen, with great distinction, an honor to introduce to you Cypress College Hall of Famer, Larry Mercadante.
I can see you got you right on this old cowboy, and I can tell you never had one for your own. You never been around one. Now you think that you found
Larry
one.
Larry is currently retired. He lives with his wife Judy in Orange, California. They have two children, Karen and Kevin. Once again, Larry Mercadante.
If I held you tight, you'd be seeing his and hers. Buckles, boots, and spurs. With that feeling, you'll get over.
Our next inductee. She spent 36 years as a Cypress College charger, working her way up from a part-time athletic trainer to the dean of the PE athletics department. She showed that hard work, loyalty, and perseverance can take you far at Cypress College. She was a part-time athletics trainer for 1 year before becoming the full-time athletics trainer for 3 years. She became a full-time PE faculty member, where she served 10 years and was awarded the 1991 Cypress College Teacher of the Year Award. She worked as the part-time athletics academic advisor for 1 year and then became the dean of the PE athletics department and athletics director. Ladies and gentlemen, an honor to present Cypress College Hall of Famer, Diane Henry. Is retired, currently lives in Westminster, California. She enjoys traveling the world in retirement, including trips to, and I have to say all of them, Costa Rica, Galapagos Islands, Tahiti, Hawaii, the Caribbean, the Sea of Cortez, and Fullerton? No, I'm just kidding. No, Cypress. That is Diane Henry, ladies and gentlemen. All right, here we go. Our next inductee has served as the ultimate charger in his role as Cypress College president from 2012 to 2017. As president of the college, he provided leadership and support, resulting in facility renovations, including new gym floors, updates to our fitness lab, and a $500,000 resurfacing of our soccer field. He has also served as an invaluable leader, educating campus constituencies about the importance of authorizing expenditures to appropriately support the physical education and athletic division. As the Orange Empire Conference CCAA CEO rep to the board, he has made significant contributions addressing equity issues for student athletes and has shown a tremendous amount of support for the Chargers' athletic faculty, staff, and programs. You can easily spot him and his wife Denise year-round at a variety of Charger athletic events. Ladies and gentlemen, Cypress College Hall of Famer, Dr. Robert Simpson.
Thank you.
orchestra at Cypress College as president before retirement begins in June. Ladies and gentlemen, let him hear it one more time, Dr. Bob Simpson.
So our first speaker, as you heard, is Hall of Famer, women's basketball state champion, and a San Jose State grad. Please welcome Brittany Amaku.
No, I'm sorry, guys. I was so excited. Like, I don't have to talk. I was happy, like, yes! So first off, I want to say good morning to everyone and thank everyone for being here this morning. Speaking on behalf of the inductees, I know this is an honor, especially for me. I'm surprised that I'm even up here. I didn't expect this. I know I wanted to leave a legacy, but to be a part of this program and part of this familyhood was so special to me. So I wrote a little few things down, so I just want to... There's a few people I want to thank. I had a speech, but I'm just going to scratch it. I'm going to speak from the heart. So first off, I want to thank Margaret Moore, because I'm a 5'2 guard, and I'm little. I didn't have a lot of opportunities. She took a chance on me, and she knew my dream was to play at the Division I level, so she pushed me to it. I want to thank my mother, because she put a basketball in my hand. Yeah, she put a basketball in my hand when my dad passed away, and it was a good outlet for me. That was the best thing she could have done. I want to thank my cousin. He's here, Edward. My older brother's not here, Brandon. But I want to thank him because they took me to the park every day playing. Growing up, they gave me somebody to look up to. I want to thank my sisters, the Chargers, Lady Charger family. I mean, it's really a sisterhood. And from people that came before me, I was playing here when I was in 10th grade playing open gym with Sharice Brown, that's actually an inductee that couldn't make it today. Triana Allen, they paved the way for me. So I knew when I finished, I paved the way for the future Charger, Lady Chargers, which are here. I'm coaching here, so I have my players here. I'm excited that they're here. And a special thanks to my teammates, my sisters. We're the grade 8. We have one state championship, not like softball, I mean. They won so many. I was chasing them. I'm not going to lie. I'm like, I got to give me a championship. I told Coach, I said freshman year, I said it to him. I said, Coach, we're going to win a championship. See, I don't think she believed me. I don't think the newspaper guy believed me my sophomore year when I said we're going to win. But I'm like, we're going to win. I believe it. I had the best freshman All-American, in my opinion, and Anna Fakatu. She couldn't be here from Utah, but she did so much for me. And two of my teammates that could be here is Breezy and Nian. They're here, and those are my sisters. They follow me. They let me lead. I'm hard to play with at times, but they let me lead. And I want to thank my coach, came all the way from San Jose, Coach T, Tamara Motson. And I just want to thank Cypress for embracing me. I mean, coming from Compton, California, you wouldn't expect the kid to be up here from the urban area. And I'm showing them that you can get out and there's other opportunities. And I got to thank Lou and Yvonne. I don't care. They the best office staff you can have. There's nobody like them. And I know I saw... Alan is here. My stat guy from my years is here. It was good to see him. Of course, Diane Henry. Now, I got to tell you the story before I go. Now, Diane says, if you guys go to state tournament, I will get you a bus. So we go to state tournament. I walk in the office like, Diane, okay, so can we have our bus, our charter bus? Diane goes, I don't know if we have that in the budget. I said, well, you said we would get a bus. So we went up in Tahoe's, and that was good enough for me. Like I was telling, one more thing, Mr. Eaton is here. And you know those numbers up there? One day my number will be up there, but I always say, man, I want to get my jersey up there like them. So I'm getting close. I got inducted with them, so I'm like, okay, I'm a little closer. Go Chargers.
Keep winning those games, Brittany. You'll be up there. All right, our final speaker of our event, none other than the legend himself. Please welcome Mark Eaton.
I had no idea that everything I needed to start my career was to be found here on this campus. I had no idea that the classes, instructors, coaches, and experience at Cypress would propel me to the next level and beyond. I had no idea. Of course, looking back some 39 years later, it's relatively easy to see the role my time at Cypress played in charting the course of my life. When I was a 21-year-old auto mechanic working at the tire store at Lincoln and Knott, things were not quite so clear. And when a Cypress College chemistry professor basketball coach named Tom Lubin walked into my life, little did I know, everything I needed was right down the street. I had no idea. From my first instruction out on the asphalt court to the rigors of wooden-style basketball under legendary coach Don Johnson and the sage training advice from Diane Henry, my adult life started to take shape. Combined with the knowledge I gained from classes in business communication, economics with Mr. Pearl, and even geology with Dottie Steller, a foundation was formed that would serve me for many years to come. I had no idea. As I look around at the esteemed guests before us today, I would hazard a guess that they too had little idea the impact what Cypress would have on their lives and the legacy they would leave in their wake. From storied athletic and coaching careers to patented products, breakthroughs in science, healthcare, and technology, this college has served as a launching pad for thousands who changed our world. We had no idea. It is a place of exploration and challenge, a place where incoming students can find a resonance within themselves as they consider and embrace new ideas and patterns of thought. My experience here transcended basketball courts and classroom walls to deeper life discussions in the coach's office on the couch and late night debriefs with eating tacos at Foster's Freeze. Throughout it all, one thing was clear. This institution, the professors, coaches, and administrators had one goal: to give a scrawny kid like me a chance to live a bigger life and acquire the skills needed to walk forward and upward to the next level. I had no idea, but now I do. And for that, I am forever grateful. Congrats to all the inductees.
We had to have the speeches. You see what I'm saying? Unbelievable. So on that note, we invite you to socialize, drink, eat, gather. At 12:30, if you'd like to make your way over to the baseball field, we are going to have a special 50th anniversary baseball pregame ceremony, which will start at 12:45 sharp, featuring a live performance of our national anthem by jazz musician and full-time faculty member Gary Gopar, along with the first ever 5-drone flyover by our aviation instructor Ed Valdez and his pilots, and acknowledging 50 years of Cypress baseball for our Hall of Famers as well as other alumni in attendance. So we invite you to come check it out. If you want to grab a bite to lunch, a bite to eat on campus, we have food trucks and an event starting shortly as well. So thank you all. Go Chargers. Great event.